Going to be reading from the New Living Translation, but it's pretty close. It's 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians chapter 6. 2 Corinthians 6, 3 through 10. Would be our main text for today. We're talking about the section is Paul's letter to the Church of Corinth about hardships endured. One of my probably my favorite character in the whole New Testament is the Apostle Paul. I don't know if you all have individual favorite characters in the Bible. But Paul is always, the more that I read through, the more that I learn, the more I become so, a fan is really the right word for Paul, but I just become so impressed by how he dealt with things in his life. Because we know he went from being a persecutor of Christians to being a Christian and being one of the greatest writers of the New Testament, and being strong and being very bold and proclaiming just things of his life and the message of the cross. I want to read through verses 3 through 10 of 2 Corinthians chapter 6. So we live in such a way that no one will stumble because of us, and no one will find fault with our ministry. In everything we do, we show that we are true ministers of God. We patiently endure troubles and hardships and calamities of every kind. We have been beaten, been put in prison, faced angry mobs, worked to exhaustion, endured sleepless nights, and gone without food. We prove ourselves by our purity, our understanding, our patience, our kindness, by the Holy Spirit within us, and by our sincere love. We faithfully preach the truth. God's power is working in us. We use the weapons of righteousness in the right hand for attack and the left hand for defense. We serve God whether people honor us or despise us, whether they slander us or praise us. We are honest, but they call us imposters. We are ignored even though we are well known. We live close to death, but we are still alive. We've been beaten, but we've not been killed. Our hearts ache, but we always have joy. We are poor, but we give spiritual riches to others. We own nothing, and yet we have everything. We all know that, as he's talking to the church in Philippi, in chapter 4, he's talking about how he learns contentment. You know, just throughout Paul's letters, he talks about his learning. But even though he knows so much, he still doesn't brag about knowing that only from Christ Jesus. And he, you know, with the people that Paul served with, you know, no matter what circumstances he was in, he encouraged the people that was with him. Stay strong. Be strong. Things are going to be hard. I mean, he was very down to earth, just like Jesus was to people. I mean, Jesus kind of laid it out. He didn't sugarcoat things. Paul didn't either. Paul said, well, this is how it is. This is how you need to live. It's going to be hard. And you don't have to read very far in the New Testament, you know, before you realize that the Apostle Paul endured a lot. And like I said, he was probably my favorite character of the whole New Testament. Than Jesus. Jesus would always be our favorite character. But it's neat to go through and see the different characters in Scripture and how they handle things. And in verse 4, we read about how Paul encourages them to always be true ministers of God. In everything we do, we want to show that we are true ministers of God. We patiently endure troubles and hardships and calamities of every kind. There, I was on the wrong line. You know, and Paul says it's about being true people. It's about being real. It's about being who we're called to be. It's not just about folding in times of trouble. And it's about being true, withstanding things, and no matter what we're going through. And we are all ministers of God. We are all ministers. It doesn't matter if we've been to Bible college, doesn't matter if we have a degree in it. If you are a follower of Christ, you are called to be a minister for Him. You are called to be. He sends us out on a great commission. Go and share with people. He calls all of us. No Christian is exempt to this command. He brings opportunities into our lives every single day to share with others. Paul was certainly one who put his best effort forward. He wasn't one to get lazy. He wasn't one to slack. Yes, he was imperfect, like anybody would be. But from what we read in the Scripture, I mean, Paul was zealous, and he was excited, and he went and he ministered, no matter what. He definitely was not treated in good ways. It doesn't take long for us to read through his letters before we see that he was, you know, severely treated, very, very poorly treated. And I mean, I could say, I don't know how to compare that to what Jesus went through, but you know, it wasn't as much, but it was, I would say it was getting up there close, because he was beaten up pretty bad. But he kept his focus. He endured. He knew that if he didn't follow God and encourage others, and he served with to do the same, he would fail. And if he failed, then he would fail leading others. He didn't want to do that. He wanted to succeed. The hardships were there, but it built his character, it built other people's character. He learned. I think if Paul were alive today and you asked him, he wouldn't brag. I think he'd say, no, it was all the Lord. It was all the Lord. The Lord did everything for me. He helped me to endure. We've all had hardships in our lives, haven't we? Home, whether it's home or work, church, family members or friends. You know, sometimes we go to family gatherings, we go to reunions, and I've heard stories here and there where they don't go so well. Families don't get along for one reason or another. People despise going to them. Some people like them. Some people, they just dread going to them because they think, great, I haven't seen that person in 20 years and I wanted to keep it that way. I mean, sometimes it just happens. People just, you know, have to endure hardships, you know, no matter where we're at, what we're doing. But hardships are part of life, and they build character within us. Troubles seem to surface when we least expect them to. Isn't that the truth? Paul definitely learned this and experienced it firsthand. But he endured most of what the rest of us probably would not be able to. We would look through his letters and see how he endured. I think we would be very careful to not say, oh, I can handle that. I don't think we could. After all he went through and survived, it would be very hard for us to handle what he did. Paul's teaching on hardships revealed to us that we should serve regardless of how we're treated and what happens to us. It doesn't matter where we're at, what we're doing. Paul's house was thrown into prison. Did they complain? No. They praised God. So depending on what we go through, a lot of times we can kind of, because of our circumstances, it determines how we act and how we treat other people. But we need to serve regardless of what happens. Paul learned to persevere no matter what was happening to him. Instead of just seeing what was happening to him at a given time or circumstance, instead of just seeing, just a limited focus, seeing what was going on, he saw the bigger picture. This is happening, but I'm not dead. This is happening, but I'm still alive. This is happening, so he would see what was at hand, but then he'd back up and look at the bigger picture. But I'm not dead. But I'm still alive. I'm still kicking. I'm still moving. I'm still preaching the gospel. He always looked at it from an extended point of view. He saw the big picture. And that's a good learning lesson for all of us. What an amazing man of God we see in Paul. If we look again here, verses 5 through 10, I'd like to read through those again. 5 through 10. We have been beaten, been put in prison, faced angry mobs, worked to exhaustion, endured sleepless nights, and gone without food. That's bad. I don't think any of us would be able to survive very long. I really don't think we would. We might say we would, but I don't think we would. We prove ourselves by our purity, our understanding, our patience, our kindness, by the Holy Spirit within us, and by our sincere love. Not them alone doing it, but God through them. That's how they were able to survive. We faithfully preach the truth. God's power is working in us. We use the weapons of righteousness in the right hand for attack and the left hand for defense. We serve God whether people honor us or despise us. Whether they slander us or praise us, we are honest, but they call us imposters. We are ignored, even though we are well known. We live close to death, but we are still alive. We have been beaten, but we have not been killed. Our hearts ache, but we always have joy. We are poor, but we give spiritual riches to others. We own nothing, and yet we have everything. See, Paul just had a different perspective on life. He was teaching others. When this is happening, when this is hard, look at what's good. And it's easy for us to look in the hard times and see, oh, life is just horrible and falling apart, which, I mean, that's a natural emotion for anybody to go through. But to back up and look at it in a different perspective, If you remember the movie Soul Surfer that came out about the girl who lost her arm, I remember one part of that movie where the youth minister was talking to the students and did a close-up picture, and everybody was like grossed out, and then backed up like, wow, I had no idea it was that. And they did another, you know, she did another picture, and then, you know, another extended view, and the students were like, wow, I didn't think it was that at all. And she said, you know, that's how life is. Sometimes we just need a different perspective when we look at life. We need to look at it at a different angle. Instead of just focusing on this one little thing and being upset, we look at the bigger picture. Hard to do. That's what Paul did. That's what he was able to do. All the things that he endured and he went through, he served regardless because he knew what his mission was, to be faithful. Talked about, you know, purity, their understanding, their patience, kindness, and love through the power of the Holy Spirit. They couldn't do it on their own. They had to do it through God's power. And the only way to prove to others that we are strong and steadfast for God through everything is just by the way we live. By the way we live. We can talk as much as we want to. We can say as many things as we want to. We can talk up the talk as much as we want. But until the walk comes through, people don't believe it. Many years ago, Michael W. Smith wrote a song called Live the Life. And it's a fantastic song. I remember one year he wrote it, but for others to see the proof, there's no better proof than to live it. If we're not living it, as Paul did, as Christ did, people will not believe us. They won't. And if we want to make an example to others through the hardships that we experience, then we need to live that life and be strong. We have to prove it. You know, a lot of talking, like people say, well, prove it. Well, we need to prove it by the way we live. Do our best to live faithfully for him, serving regardless. And in verse 8, Paul makes it very clear to serve God whether people honor or despise us, whether they slander or praise us. And that's hard to do because everything's hunky-dory when we're getting praised and when people are great with us. Hey, it's peachy, wonderful. People will like us. Hey, that's great. Then when the slander comes in and people despise us, that's hard. Very, very hard. It's easy to treat people nicely when they're good to us, but it's hard when they're mean to us. Very hard. Paul goes on to say in verse 9, to say they lived close to death, but they still lived. No matter how far he and the people he served with came close to death, they still survived. They looked at the bigger picture. They were beaten, but they weren't killed. Instead of focusing on the bad treatment, Paul rejoices. He rejoices. Again, many of us would not be that way. If not, most of us would not be that way. And in verse 10, he clearly stated that even though their hearts ache, they still have joy. Why? Because of who they were serving. If it's Christ that we're serving, no matter what we go through, we can have joy. And Paul says that. If you just realize who you're serving, you're going to have troubles, you're going to have heartaches, you're going to have hard things happen to you. But if you stay in faith and you stay strong, you'll be okay. If you turn with me back a couple chapters, I'm going to be reading out the NIV to chapter 4, 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 7 through 10. But we have this treasure in jars of clay to show that this all-surpassing power is from God, not from us. We are hard-pressed on every side, but not crushed. Perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not abandoned. Struck down, but not destroyed. We always carry around in our body the death of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may also be revealed in our body. For we who are alive are always being given over to death for Jesus' sake, so that his life may be revealed in our mortal body. So then death is at work in us, but life is at work in you. More encouragement from the Apostle Paul. Being strong. Being strong through the hardships, no matter what they are, whether they're really, really big or something just kind of small happening to us. And we have big and small things happening to us a lot. We really do. It just depends on where we are and what's happening to us. Paul discusses hardships and how even though we get beaten down, we still have hope, knowing that we carry the message of the cross. Jesus carried that message of the cross. Paul did as well. Many others did. But looking at Paul today, we see that he carried that message. Paul served regardless of how he was treated. And he encouraged those he taught and led the same. He served regardless of what was in his path. He stayed true to the Word of God and persevered. That's encouragement. Why is it encouragement? Because some human being that really lived in the Bible, that really lived and wrote part of the Bible, he lived it. It's not just a myth. It's a real story, a real person, a real human being that wasn't extraordinary, that was ordinary, and God made him extraordinary. And he lived and he survived. And that is a testimony to us that we can do the same thing. Paul says we can. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. That's been a memorized verse for many people without thinking about it. But Paul says, I have learned to be content. I have learned to be happy. I have learned what it means to be content. It didn't come naturally to him. He learned. Paul encourages us that in life, we need to man our post. I was thinking of that phrase this last week, man your post. And the times I've heard that about people that are in service, when they need to be on guard for when they get attacked. Being alert, manning your post. And I'd like to read from the Message translation. Occasionally, I like to look at the Message translation. I'm going to read 2 Corinthians 6, 3-10 from the Message. Companions, as we are in this work with you, we beg you, please don't squander one bit of this marvelous life God has given us. God reminds us, I heard your call in the nick of time. The day you needed me, I was there to help. Well, now is the right time to listen. The day is the day to be helped. Don't put it off. Don't frustrate God's work by showing up late. Throw in a question mark over everything we're doing. Our work as God's servants gets validated or not in the details. People are watching as we stay at our post, alertly, unswervingly. In hard times, tough times, bad times, when we're beaten up, jailed, mobbed, working hard, working late, working without eating, work with pure heart, clear head, steady hand, and gentleness, holiness, and honest love. When we're telling the truth and when God shows his power. When we're doing our best, setting things right. When we're praised and when we're blamed. Slandered and honored. True to our word and distrusted. Ignored by the world, but recognized by God. Terrifically alive, though rumored to be dead. Beat within an inch of our lives, but refusing to die. Immersed in tears, yet always filled with deep joy. Living on handouts, yet enriching many. Having nothing, having all. Paul knew that it wasn't anything in life, anything tangible, that meant he had everything. He had Christ, and that meant he had everything. But again, it didn't come easy to him. He had to learn that. He had to strive for that. And the power of the Holy Spirit through him, and God on his side, he could do it. He endured so much. It's a different perspective reading this translation. I read this several times and thought, well, you know, sometimes the Message is kind of a little weird sounding in some of the passages, but this one, just the way of describing it, people are watching us as we stay at our post. People are watching us. They're looking to see what we're going to do, especially people who are unsaved and don't know Christ. You know, this is a kind of a different perspective of, you know, looking at life and how we can be attacked by the enemy. He brings adversities to our life. You know what people pay attention to most is how we react to them. How we react. Not just who we say we are, but that when hard times come, we respond right, we respond with love, we respond with compassion, with understanding, not with anger. You know, Paul's saying it's so important not just to be full of life and full of God, where people are coming at you and they're attacking you, the enemy's attacking you. Be strong. Man, you were supposed to be alert. What if somebody, you know, that was in the service was, you know, fighting, and all of a sudden the enemy came up and they weren't paying attention? Just like that, they're gone, right? Could happen. Same thing happens with us if we're not manning our post, if we're not taking care of things in our life and being ready, being on alert, being in the Word. Satan can come up and attack us when we least expect it and pull us way down. People are watching us. And that's not supposed to kind of freak you out and be like, oh, great, that's kind of creepy. People are watching me. But we do need to live that way. We need to live as if somebody is watching us all the time. Our actions, our words, the way we do things. We don't even have to say a word. Our actions alone can be living that life of Christ and then saying, you know what? You didn't need to say a word. I saw how you reacted. You're like Christ. You can be an example to people just by the way that you act and react. for Him? Are we a witness in everything that we are doing? I hope so. What's most important for all of us today to realize and remember is that staying true to God is the key. Staying true to Him. If we're not prepared, if we're not alert, if we're not holding unswervingly to truth, the enemy will throw things at us and we will fail. We have to be ready and alert. So we would remain strong through hardships and troubles. It not only strengthens our faith, but it sends a message to others that even if they don't agree with what we believe and stand for, in their mind they're thinking, wow, that person is the real deal. They're really the real deal. They mean what they say. They don't agree with them, but they mean what they say. In the movie, I think many of you have seen the movie Fireproof. And in that movie, they're in the fire station. This one guy is all religious and talking. And the two guys come together and say, what do you think about all that? And they said, well, we may not believe all anything he believes, but we know he's the real deal. Do people know we're the real deal? Whether they agree with us or not. You know, you don't have to agree with them. Oh, you don't? No. You don't have to agree with them all the time. We don't always agree. But we need to have that love in our heart and showing them the love of Christ. Paul was loving in what he did, but he was firm, standing up for what he believed in. We also need to be loving, but be firm. Not being mean to people, but being loving and firm. How is our character? How is our character, especially when nobody else is watching, when nobody else is around us? How are we dealing with things? God is always watching us. Are we enduring hardships like Paul did? Whether he was alone or around others, he made sure to be a witness to the mighty power of God. Are we staying true to God's word and our service to Him no matter what we experience? It's a challenge for each one of us to consider, not only today, but every day. Do we grow through the hardships, or will you suffer from them and not learn? And it's pretty sad when we don't suffer from them. I hope we learn. When we make mistakes, yes, that's just part of life. Sometimes we fall, we don't learn a lesson, we have to learn it the next time. God gives us a lot of chances. After the 10th time, we're like, man, can I learn? But sometimes it happens that way. But God will keep teaching us and keep teaching us. The hardships that Paul went through are what built his character. And he tells us that. You know, all the things he went through, the turmoil he went through, but it wasn't just him that went through it. The Lord went through it too. And because Jesus went through it, Paul knew that he could sustain too. That's why he suffered, because he knew he wasn't just suffering to suffer. He was suffering for Christ. No matter whether we're experiencing minimal hardships or extremely difficult hardships, are we staying strong and staying true to what he commands us to do? It's hard. Life is difficult. Life is hard. You never know what curveballs the enemy's going to throw at us, what unexpected things he's going to do. We never know. And again, Paul, throughout the New Testament, shares with us many things that he learned. And I hope today that just hearing this, it encourages you, the hardships in your life that you're experiencing, that you can get through them. Why? Because Christ did, Paul did, many other people did, and we can do all things through Christ.